instead put together by Mary, Mary, indeed the sun will shine in the morning. So you should always be hopeful. I mean, Christ died and has resurrected. So there's hope for us in the Christendom. Moving on now to the newspaper review. So much happening, but I'm starting with the Punch newspaper. I'm also reviewing the Nigerian Tribune. I am reviewing the Daily Trust newspaper. Benjamin?
Okay. Well, on this end, we have the Guardian, the Daily Sun, and of course the New Telegraph. So, Wofa, you kick off with the Punch.
Yes, we're starting with the Punch newspaper. The major headlines on the Punch is on the arms scandal. We haven't forgotten about the arms scandal. It says Jonathan can be tried if there is evidence. That's coming from Buhari's panel, and that's on page 2. Jonathan can be tried if there is evidence. Buhari's panel. Still on the Punch, gunmen abduct Colonel in Kaduna. That's on page 8, coming from the governor of Kaduna State. Metu lied. I didn't know him. Abang tells CJ. That's on page 7. And on fuel scarcity, South, South, Southeast APC back Tinubu against Kachifu. That's on page 8. Alleged subsidy fraud. EFCC revisits case against Babanikoro's son. That's on page 2 of the Punch newspaper. AFCON charts withdrawal dims Eagles' hope. That's on page 45 of the Punch. Dollar scarcity. Foreign airlines raises fares by 100%. That's on page 29. PDP battles ghost workers. Pay staff in cash. That's on page 10. And that's coming from Sheriff. UNILAG students arrested for attempting to resurrect buried colleague. That's on page 5 of the Punch newspaper. There's several headlines here.
Of course, Jonathan can be tried.
If there is evidence.
Well, somebody said he does not think that the Buhari administration will ever think of trying Jonathan because if Jonathan is tried, then quite a number of heads of state will need to go that way.
But the other hand, looking at it categorically, the monies, talking about the arms deal and the monies that were involved in it, were these monies paid directly to Jonathan's personal account?
Of course, but as a president, he gave an order, released the money, and he expected them to do whatever they needed to do. Okay, so somebody was also arguing that Jonathan might not exactly know what went wrong. Okay, we quickly take a look at the Guardian. NNPC spends 103.4 billion naira to protect oil pipelines in 1 year. It has three riders. Corporation loses 57.71 billion to vandalism. 2,832 vandalized points recorded in 13 months, 400 in 2016. And Ghana may dump Nigeria, looks elsewhere for gas supply. Nigeria to become West Africa's internet transmission hub, still on the front page of the Guardian. And presidency counters Tinubu on Kachiku, fuels Kashti, Balarabe Musa Okupe, Babatope Ekumba Difa. And on page 4, why Buhari is yet to disclose recovered loot by aid. And of course, Akinde Kumuyi, APC urge peace, tolerance, return to godliness. Okay, Wofai, Nigerians are actually itching to know how much has been collected so far. And, the news we're hearing is that the president said he cannot. I think he's been in one of the papers.
Yes, I think he's one of the other papers. I totally agree with Nigerians if they're itching to know how much has been recovered from the looted ones. Because we keep hearing $500 billion was looted. This particular amount has been recovered. Where are the recovered monies going to? A lot of people don't have ideas. How much exactly has been recovered? But on the other hand, if you look at what the president is saying categorically, if I release the numbers of the figures of this monies that has been released, it might, you know, stall the processes in court.
Nigerians are
actually working. These courts already have ideas of what's going on. So moving on to the Nigerian Tribune. The screaming headlines on the Nigerian Tribune says, Easter without fail. Nigerians struggle at filling station, queue for hours. Pay between 140 naira and 250 naira per liter. Transport fares skyrocket. Nigerians are suffering. That's coming from the Northern CAN, CAN. Civil society groups threaten murder of all protests on Wednesday. APC vice chairman calls for Kachiku's resignation. That's on page 2, 3, and 12 of the Nigerian Tribune. Other stories on the Nigerian Tribune. Army colonel abducted in Kaduna. That's on page 5. Security in Nigerian airports to gulp 25 billion naira. That's on page 5. Ondo begins Lawyers Week production. That's on page 29. Why recovered loot can't be made public now. That's coming from the president. And that's on page 3. The writer says to embark on town hall meetings. I am particular about the story on APC vice chairman calling for Kachiku's resignation. Kachiku is the Minister of State for Petroleum. We have a Minister for Petroleum who should oversee all the activities in the sector. If anyone was to call for anybody's resignation, I think it should be the Minister's resignation. And that's Mr. President resigning as the Minister for Petroleum, not the Minister for State.
Well,
that's just my own opinion anyway.
We'll just hope that the fuels issue is resolved. Okay, we'll quickly take a look at the Daily Sun. And it has this very interesting headline. Fuels casty, Tinubu's letter bomb. PDP, APC can speak. Nigerians divided. You can get that on page 6. And APC divided over scrapping of BOT. We are restructuring party, says Oyego. You can get that on page 7. And recovered loots. Why we can't disclose amount. This is coming from the President Buhari on page 6. An army colonel kidnapped as headsmen kill 4 policemen, page 4, 5, and 12. And finally, Biafra, IPOB, blows hot, threatens to cripple Nigeria, on page 9. You can get details of that if you pick up the Daily Sun.
Moving on now to the Daily Trust newspaper. The Daily Trust newspaper has a screaming headline saying, Kano market fire update, 2 trillion naira goods lost. Traders, 3,800 shots bombed. That's coming from NEMA. 2 trillion naira goods lost. That's coming from the traders. And that's on page 5 of the Daily Trust newspaper. Gunmen kidnap army colonel. That's on page 4 of the Daily Trust newspaper. Why board appointments are delayed. That's coming from the presidency. And that's on page 4 of the Daily Trust newspaper. Equity varsity to float bakery, block industries. That's on page 7 of the Daily Trust. Easter, leaders recommend Christ teachings on peace. That's on page 10. Federal government requires 25 billion naira to fence 22 airports. That's on page 17. It's 714 days since over 200 Chibok schoolgirls were taken by Boko Haram. And of course, the pictorial showing beneficiaries of free train ride from Lagos to Osun State, sponsored by the Osun State government in commemoration of the Easter at Edo Terminal in Lagos yesterday. Our trains are working. Our terminals are working.
Definitely. That's good news. And quickly now, still on the headlines this morning, we'll take a look at the New Telegraph. And still talking about the fuels casting. Resign now, APC tells Kachiku with a rider. Tinubu lacks moral right to criticize minister. That's a reaction from the PDP. You can get that on page 2. And terror, massive security deployed in public buildings. Orders, we have taken serious security measures, says the DHQ, Director of Headquarters, page 3. And Sharif intensifies campaign to remain in office, page 5. 100 held for looting after Kano market fire, page 9. Nigerian rapes British woman in Dubai, page 9. And gunmen abduct army colonel in Kaduna. You can get that on page 3. And at the topmost part of that paper, presidency kicks over dilution of federal government stakes in Transcorp Hilton. It has a rider, due process followed, says BP. You can get all that on the front page of the New Telegraph. Wofai, I think it's not been quite an interesting Easter holiday, really. But again, people still went out to catch fun. Whatever the situation is, there seemed to be some level of decorum. If this had happened during the Christmas or the New Year break, possibly it could have been some street match.
I disagree with you, but the most I would say is that the administration of President Muhammadu Buhari should get its house together and, you know, fix the problems that the nation is facing. Yes, it's okay to fight corruption, it's okay to preach the anti-graft war, but you need to fix the other things that are very important for Nigerian citizenry to exist properly.
Okay, it's been a wonderful time. Those are the stories on the front pages of the newspapers. You can go out there and pick any of them and get the details. Well, like you said, we're going to be spicing up the special broadcast with musical, Christian musical videos, and I'm sure